Hey guys, welcome back. Today we are going to be continuing our renovation slash we actually started moving things in. So in the next few days here, the plan is this place will be ready and open for public viewing. Let me turn you guys around. Got the four post, couch, counter, and actually most of our tools. Well, not mine per se, but Angus and Eddie's. I have yet to move any of my stuff here, but I'm still cleaning this place up. But this mezzanine area, the plan is we're gonna be painting the walls. It's gonna be almost like the shop we have currently, where the back wall is green and the rest of the walls are white, just to keep it bright to reflect the light. And also today, I picked up some extra board here because we're gonna be doing some dangerous things. On the outside here, gotta pretty it up, kind of finish off the border before we paint any of this. So if you go downstairs, oh man. You guys get the idea, right? I don't know where that couch is going. It might actually go in the front room. That thing is portable. We can actually move that. We can actually move that lift anywhere in this shop. So
in terms of where anything's gonna go, we have yet to figure that out, but we kind of have a small idea. It's just right now, first priority is painting these walls and really cleaning this place up.
What's up, guys?
Let's start.
What? I just got here.
I know.
But yeah, so Angus, Eddie, these guys have been busy putting on the baseboards in the front.
So let me take you guys there right now. This is actually my first time. Oh my gosh. I only saw photos, but I mean, right now it's kind of footprints all over the place, especially in this kind of weather. So inevitable, but you guys get the gist.
Damn. And this is really easy to clean up too, so no problems there. Yes! Oh my goodness.
This is it, guys. Oh, and they've been working on cleaning up the printer room. Let me put you guys down. Damn. Okay, so this is the laminator. What the camera is sitting on right now is the actual printer or die cutter. And we have a huge printer in the other room, which I'll show you guys in a bit. That's gonna be taking care of all of our stickers. So we can actually make our decals or decals, however you guys wanna pronounce it. All Canadians say decals, but Americans make fun of me when I say decal. So decal, decal, whatever. But we'll be able to make those, or just stickers in general, in-house. Plus, the plotter that we got, you know what, let me just show you guys right now.
Here's the printer. This thing's massive.
So we can actually start printing our own Itashas, basically, like full vehicle, full color, full length wrap.
That's insane. I wanna know your name,
man. I wanna know if you got a man. So this is gonna be the sticker room, and we'll be able to do everything in house. Pretty cool. And then we're gonna have doors here just in case, so it's not really open to public. And then this huge open space, which we took like 2 weeks renovating ourselves, painting the walls ourselves, knocking down all the walls and all the wiring for the lights ourselves. Shout out to So Scare Bear for helping us out on that part. This was a huge learning experience for all of us. So yeah, I'm actually pretty proud. And now I know how to basically do my own drywall. So the color we ended up going with the walls, which is actually a deep green. Forgot what the actual specific name of it is called, but it's called Emerald, and I got it at Home Depot. This color is not black. It's actually called Nightclub, and it's a very, very dark gray. And you can tell that there's a difference because we ended up painting the door sills black, and I actually kind of like that contrast.
And then all the walls on that side are black, whereas the back walls are green, so that if you go outside, kind of hard to see right now, but if it's dark, all you see is green. Ay.
To me, I like the idea of open space. Yeah, it's just in my character. I don't like closed meetings and secrecy and the idea of behind doors stuff. And that explains why I was never into like corporate business and getting a job in a cubicle. That was never me. But it was in everyone's interest to just break down the walls and have this place as open as possible. Because in the previous video, this room that we're in right now used to be enclosed as the kitchen or like the break room area. But my idea now for this room is to have it part retail and maybe like a waiting room for our customers. And then down there, the idea is to have a counter right here with all of the company's brands as like neon signs or something. We're just gonna have all of the KMR merch available here for all of the Calgary locals. That's the plan anyway. It's just, I don't actually know where everything's gonna go yet, but it'll make it easier when we move everything here and then just play around. This particular black blank wall leading into the decal room is gonna be my next canvas for the next week. I have such a sick idea for this wall and maybe I'll save it. Or here, quick second. You guys get a gist of my idea. This is gonna be like a hype beast wall where people can come in and take photos in front of it because it's gonna be that sick. Yeah.
Actually, I think it'd be smart to just keep a Swiffer in here.
Have they invented like a Swiffer Roomba yet? We're actually given a lot of room here, which is awesome. Remember guys, the plan was always to outgrow ourselves and took 5 years to get here, but I'm actually surprised at where we are right now. Can't take that for granted, so just keep pushing through and who knows man, outgrow ourselves in the next five. Baby girl, you're
so damn fine, though. Wanna know if I can hit it from behind, though. So, we're gonna take some wall mud and we're gonna try and fill in all of these cracks so that this entire wall is flush and not so patchy looking. But yeah, everywhere, and then like in areas like this, probably gonna have to lift it up. So that's where it'll come in handy. Just try to fill in all of the cracks using the wall mud. Talking bands, I got it. Benjamin's in my pocket. I traded in my truth for some robbers. And he's playing Batman. Fatty's gonna rob him. Yeah. I got the Glock in my Robin. 17 shots, no 38. Yeah, I got the Glock in my Robin. 17 shots, no 38. Get a little test. So we're gonna be painting this entire top part black, and we'll start with this door frame, and then we'll move on to the stairs and probably this wooden ledge thing. I don't even know why they made the stairs like a foot away from the wall. They could have just put it to the wall, but yeah, could be extra storage. We're gonna be painting that way.
Back at the home studio, and I think I'm just gonna end the video, guys. And honestly, well, first of all, the camera ran out of batteries. I forgot the extra battery and the charger at home. Plus, it started becoming a chore running back and forth to turn the camera on and off. And you guys have been watching me paint for the past 2 days, but you should see the place now, next episode. And if you guys are actually following me on Instagram, you probably have seen hints here and there. I like to share more up-to-date posts on my story. Supporters on my Instagram actually get like sneak previews before anyone else in the world, so you guys should follow me there. My new one anyway. My old accounts, Kings Mr. Oz and It's Birdie, still haven't had any luck trying to retrieve those, so if anyone out there has connections to anyone at Instagram or Facebook, it would be tremendous help. But how I look at it is my It's Birdie art account was actually at a plateau, and I couldn't find a way to get past the character that I created for myself, which was a guy who drew cute Pokemon art. And I noticed too, when I started posting more car stuff as opposed to the regular art, it didn't do as well as my mainstay, which is pretty much what got me here. Me losing my Instagram accounts gave me the opportunity to kind of reinvent myself this year, and that's when I decided to go full-time car YouTuber. It was pretty much around like April, beginning of quarantine for the world. Yeah, that's it guys. I'm gonna call it a night, and also I have to edit this video. Vlog miss. We'll see you guys tomorrow, I guess. It's just